Hi, I'm Patrick Zafolle. I'm an innovation architect at Delta Lloyd Nationale Nederlanden, and I'm going to talk a little bit about a method I created for designing high-quality REST APIs. The REST API is a connector to the Internet of Things, and because the main protocol on the Internet of Things is HTTP, a better name would be HTTP interface. This makes the REST API probably the most important part of the digital enterprise. In fact, to the rest of the things on the Internet of Things, the whole enterprise becomes just another HTTP server. Now, how do we design great interfaces for this HTTP server? I explained this in two infographics, which you can find at my slideshare.net/PatrickZafolle. One of them is the quick overview. This quick overview establishes a common vocabulary and a common view on the REST API. And the other one is the actual method you can follow. And there are some design patterns. Let's take a look first at the reference chart. There are some elements on the chart. I suggest you download the PDF and print it on an A3 or bigger. One of the elements here explains the REST model is just one of the models we make of the enterprise, and all the models should be compatible. They all show different views or different aspects or different parts of the enterprise, but they have to be compatible with each other. The other one here is there's some design forces to consider when you're creating this API. External forces, internal forces, everything has to fit. You have to be able to build it. Just to be understandable from the outside. And over here are things we associate with the APIs. Probably the most important things when creating REST APIs is one, you have to understand that the entire enterprise becomes just an HTTP server. The clients perceive the entire enterprise as an HTTP server. And two, this server projects all its resources, so all the enterprise resources are projected onto URLs with which clients can manipulate them. And three is, this is the definition of an API, all the requests the server can handle form its REST API. So those three things are important to keep in mind when designing the API. The other infographic is the actual design method, a process. On the left side, there is the process. On the right side, there are some design patterns I created. The first thing you do when you start designing APIs is creating the underlying logical data model. This is an outward-facing model, so it's not a secret. You have to publish them. You can publish them to the clients also. They look a little bit like this. I expect you know what data modeling is. This is actually a class model I created for bank assurance, but it's not difficult to see the data model in it. There are the entities, there are the different associations, and very important is you model also the multiplicities of the associations. So this is a one-to-many relationship, this is a many-to-many, this is leave them in, don't normalize them. This is not a technical data model, this is a logical data model. The first thing you create is the logical data model. This is the public view on the resources of the enterprise. This is your starting point. The next thing you do is you take all the entities in this data model and you assign endpoints to them. And an endpoint, of course, let's zoom in a little. An endpoint, of course, is a verb with which the client indicates whether it should be updated, created, read, or deleted, and a URL. Well, this URL is a tricky part because when do we use flat, non-hierarchical URLs, or when do we use nested URLs? For this, I created some design patterns on the other side. It's very straightforward. It follows from the data model, from the multiplicities actually. You can use them. I will explain one of them. For instance, when there is a composition relationship. Composition means the parts cannot live without the whole. Like here, there can be no travelers without the trip. This is indicated by the one. This is a composition relationship. In that case, the childs, the parts, get these nested URLs. And when there's, in this case, there can be no travelers without the trip. There can be no tickets without the traveler, indicated again by the ones, which indicate the composition relationship. And this means you can follow the trail. We get these hierarchical URLs. This is very simple, very straightforward, but you need a fairly high quality data model for it. The third step is the API, of course, is already written down in step two. These are the endpoints of the API. You have to match them against the use cases you like to support, the user journeys you like to support. So I suggest you draw out some business process model, BPMN2 diagrams, and you try to fit these endpoints to the different process steps. There has to be a good fit. If not, you have to iterate. So this is the process. This is the overview. You can download them from where am I? I've lost my way. You can download them from my slide share. Let's look at, oh, here is it, sorry. Yeah, this is a little bit confusing. This is the Brilliant Parallels tool, which allows me to use Windows and Mac on the same desktop. So I hope this will help you create high quality REST APIs. If you need my help, if you need advice, or if you detect you have improvements or you see something that is wrong, please don't hesitate to call me or to mail me. My email address is patrick.savalle@nn-group.com. Well, let's build some APIs then.